This is the most annoying sound in the world. The main reasons your shoulders are making that annoying clicking sound is due to weakness of the rotator cuff muscles and the inability to pull the shoulder back and stabilize it in the joint, and tightness in all the muscles surrounding the shoulder, pulling it forward, putting pressure on the front of the joint and the tendons. So I'm going to show you exactly how to address these issues. You're going to follow along with me. We're going to go through the exercises together. You're going to make sure you're doing them properly so you never hear that nasty clicking sound again in your shoulder. So the first exercise we're gonna do is gonna be a stretch to work shoulder extension, because we spend a lot of time with our arms forward, causing the shoulder to round forward. So we're gonna get an intense stretch all in the front of that shoulder capsule. So coming down on the mat here, I want you to start with your hands behind you. Now, depending on how tight you are, your hands might need to come a little bit wider. I suggest starting slightly wider than shoulder width. I want you to tuck your elbows back, squeeze your shoulder blades. From there, we're just gonna start. Engage your core, just rock the hips back and forth, slowly opening up into that position. Now, as I sink further, there's an increased stretch in the front of my shoulder here. So I want you to just start, squeeze the shoulders back, lift up, sitting down, and just holding and breathing here. This shouldn't be the most intense stretch in the world, but you should definitely start to feel the stretch in this position. Keep breathing, keep squeezing the shoulder blades together. And then the next option from here, if you want to make that more tense, straighten out the legs, wiggle the bum a little bit more forward, and just start and breathe here. And again, a modification, if this is a little bit difficult, is you can come to that same position. You're going to bend the elbows this time, bring them closer. So instead of having them straight, bend the elbows and then sink forward. Allows you to also get a really nice stretch in the front of the shoulder there, but it's going to modify the flexibility demands. So really spend some time. We're going to hang out and breathe for 30 seconds here. I know it's getting intense. Keep breathing. We're almost done. Sink deeper if you need to into that position. Maybe wiggle the hands a little bit closer together. Last 10 seconds. Slowly coming out, backing up, pressing through the feet. Sitting back, and we finished our first stretch. See how amazing and open your shoulders feel. So now we're gonna move on to the PNF sleeper stretch. This stretch is also gonna help improve the mobility in your shoulder joints. So start by lying on your side. I suggest a foam roller or a yoga block to keep your head in a nice comfortable position. Now, the biggest mistake here is I want your elbow exactly aligned with your shoulder and your shoulder slightly pulled back. I don't want it up here, right in that position, where it's nice and aligned. Now don't roll your body back. Keep your body nice and stacked. From here, we're gonna slowly warm up the joint, coming back and forward. Now I don't want you to force it and crank down right away. I want you to slowly just feel a little bit of a stretch right along here, coming into that external rotation position. So we're just warming up the joint here. Gonna go a few times back and forth, progressively sinking deeper, but not putting too much force through the motion. And then after we've done a few more, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one coming forwards. We're gonna see where that arm falls. We're gonna gently press down with about 30% of our strength here, just matching the resistance from my hand. We're gonna hold that for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, relax. Sink just a tad deeper. Again, if you're feeling like your arm can only get up here, don't force the stretch. We're gonna spend some time slowly lowering down. So for me, this isn't even about half of my stretch in terms of max depth at the moment. So I'm slowly again pressing out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let that relax, come a little bit deeper. Keep breathing nice and slow in through your nose, out through your mouth. One more time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and coming a little bit further. Feeling that stretch along the back of the shoulder. The last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do another contract, relax, and pressing down, pressing down, pressing down. Good, and relax, sink it deeper. Hold that at the end here. Nice 15, 20 seconds together. Make sure throughout the duration of this that your elbow hasn't translated down towards your hips.
And 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent. Slowly make your way out of that.
Now I want you to make sure to do this on both sides. So if you want to follow along with me again, you can rewind the video and use my guidance or set a timer for making sure you're doing at least a minute to 90 seconds on both sides. Now we're gonna really open up your shoulder external rotators, continuing that theme of pulling the shoulder back, but now we're gonna add a little bit more strength to these motions. Now, same thing here, the alignment is so crucial. I want your elbow to be aligned with your shoulder. Now, instead of letting that shoulder pop forward like most people do when they stretch the chest, I want you to retract your scapula and your shoulder blades. So see that little motion? I'm pulling my shoulder back. I want you to lock in that position here. Now from here, you're gonna gently press your elbow into the squat rack, externally rotate, so just lifting, pivoting from the shoulder, lifting the forearm off there, and we're gonna rotate away. I want you to continue to pivot and twist and reach back. We're gonna hold this for a good 30 to 45 seconds here. Now if you're cramping in those external rotators, just relax a little bit how much you're pressing that elbow into the squat rack. Keep holding, sinking deeper. Find the relaxation in the discomfort of the stretch here as we slowly peel the chest open, keeping that shoulder blade retracted. Keep reaching back with the hand, externally rotating through the shoulder. Keep pivoting away. We're almost there. 20 more seconds. Keep reaching back. Keep pressing that elbow, engaging all the muscles. You've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relaxing that hand down, slowly making your way out of that stretch. Now again, make sure you do this on both sides and see how your external rotation feels after you've opened up into that stretch. You can do multiple sets here of 30, 45 seconds for optimal results, because it can be a little uncomfortable to be holding this for 2 minutes at a time. So feel free to make those modifications to get the most out of these movements. So the next exercise we're going to be doing is to improve your scapular strength and the shoulder blades, help you pull those shoulders back. We're going to be doing one of my favorite exercises, the scapula push-up. Now we're going to start with a variation on the knees for the beginners watching this workout, and then we're going to come into the full plank position to really get that strengthening through the shoulder blades. So come on down with me onto your hands and knees here. We're going to come making sure your shoulder is right over the wrist and the knee is right under the hip. Coming slightly wider than shoulder width, I want you to tuck your toes, squeeze your abdominals in. Slowly, without bending the elbows, I want you to externally rotate. So turn that elbow belly forward. This movement occurs at your shoulder. Squeeze the shoulder blades together again without bending the elbows. Exhale as you press away. So we're really working on scapula control and mobility. But I don't want you to see you turning those elbows out and then bringing it together. This is functional straight arm strengthening, so those elbows stay nice and locked, squeezing the shoulder blades together, and then pushing away. Now, once you're comfortable with doing at least 10 reps in this position, I want you to come up into your tall plank here. Same thing, making sure those elbows are turned nice and forward. I want you to squeeze your shoulder blades together. I like to think of imagining that I'm pinching a pencil in between my shoulder blades. So we're going to inhale down. Exhale, push away, pausing at the top. Slowly bring the shoulder blades together. Exhale, push away. Now you can experiment with bringing the arms a little bit wider, seeing how that feels. Squeezing the shoulder blades together. Exhale, protract, push away. We call this top position the hollow body position. We're going to do 4 more together. Slowly down. Exhale, push away. That's 1. 2, exhale, 3, 4, almost there, guys, last one. Now this is such a great exercise, not only for getting rid of that annoying clicking sound in your shoulder, but also improving your scapular strength, fixing your rounded shoulders, improving your posture. There's countless benefits. The movement we're actually going through is scapular protraction and retraction. This is gonna help with your scapular movement as well as your overhead shoulder mobility. So making sure you're choosing the appropriate variation here, and then we're gonna move on to the last exercise in the video. So we just went through four of my favorite exercises to get rid of that annoying clicking sound in your shoulder. And if you want a bonus exercise, you have to check out this other video made, three exercises to never injure your shoulder again. These are my favorite rotator cuff strengthening exercises you need to be doing as a bonus to this workout we just did together today to make sure that shoulder clicking goes away forever. But not just that, to make sure you never injure your shoulder again. So check out the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And don't forget, use the code THEATHLETICPHYSIO25 to save 25% off our athletic mobility program. Like and subscribe. We'll see you in the next video. And as always, you gotta stay fit.